by 5, also from Yuming Primary School.
So for this lesson, it will be
Techniques of Definite Integral, Chapter 2, Special Functions. So in this lesson, we'll prove this whole thing.
Okay.
So to prove this whole thing, we have two parts.
Which two?
First is these two. You need to prove these two are equal. Then we can show you the first. Then the second part is the first and the third.
Yep.
Okay.
First part is first and second, no third.
Now,
the second part is first and third, no second.
Now what types of functions have we learned? What did we learn for those functions?
Beta function, gamma function.
Yes, those two types of functions we have learned them, right?
Yes.
So first, let's prove this part. Well, this looks quite hard. Does it look hard?
A bit. I think so.
But actually, it is very simple.
Wait.
Why? Later, you would know why. So, can you let something like this?
Okie doke.
Then, x, it will need to be equal to pi over 2 minus theta, right?
Yes, sir.
So, for this, I'll just write this beside.
Okay.
So, then for this, but when we have this, is actually that we'll need to change this here, right?
Yes.
Then, what can we have next? We of course need to find the range, right?
Yep.
So now, what is the range for theta?
For theta, 0 to half pi in?
Yes, 0 to half pi. Pi.
Yay, yay, yay.
So, for this sign, well, we'll just write this first.
Okay.
Then next, what did you know from the sine and the cosine? Well, can you write out something at that side?
Okay.
Now, how can we change the sine to a cosine just like this? Meanwhile, I'll continue with mine. So, I know that we have these right now.
Yeah.
So, but sine, this thing, is just straight away equal to cosine theta. Now, what happened?
Nothing.
So, we'll use this negative. Change the boundaries.
Okay.
Wait. I wrote this wrongly. You didn't realize that.
Is it half pi to 0 instead?
Yes.
And you have to take out the negative.
Like this.
Yes, sir.
Then, sine to cosine.
Okay.
Now, does this variable matter?
No, but over.
So the variable doesn't matter. So can we change it back to x?
Yes. So we don't need to sub back, okay? Okay?
Okay.
Don't
worry. Is this right?
Yeah.
Are you sure about that?
No, but you already done it at that step.
Variables here must match up.
Right? Okay, different variable, different answer. If they're not the same.
Okay, so this is what we get.
Got.
Right?
Got
so it proved for this first part.
So got it for the first part?
Yes. Then next, we can prove from this sign to this whole bunch of stuff.
And why that stuff?
This whole thing.
Okay.
Well, we have two cases for that, when n is even and when n is an odd.
Yes.
So, erase.
Okay.
Okay, so next. Now, what do we have?
Let's first give some examples about the gamma and theta function.
Okay, so let me start with this second part.
Okay.
Well, we can have two methods. One method is the one that you said, beta function. And another method is we have learned before in chapter 1, the introduction, the method number 3. Now, what is method 1?
Symmetric among.
So, number 1. We have that. Oh, is it the symmetric property?
Yes.
Or the integrand, right?
Yep.
Then the second, well, what do we have it? Corresponding integrand, right?
Corresponding integrand, the reduction.
Yes, and now is the fourth, special functions, right?
Okay.
So now for this, about our reduction. Wait, did we prove this before? It looks so familiar.
Yep.
So let's try this again.
We start. What I mean by restart means do it.
And then we have this thing. So how should we change it into this thing?
How? But how can we change it?
Let me see. Can we just have a sine square to go out first?
Okay.
Really sure about that?
Nay.
So we'll just take out the sine first, okay?
Yes.
Now, this sine x, can we put it in the dx?
Yes, sir. What I mean by yes, sir?
So, we have something that look like this.
Okay.
So, right now. What did we have here? Wait a second. Can we use sine square x equals whatever blah blah blah?
Yes.
Then you're totally wrong.
I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
Then what do we use?
We use another one.
Then what's that other one?
That other one is the negative version.
Negative version.
Just kidding. There's no such thing as negative version, okay?
Guess what am I using now? How did you know?
If not, why be like that? And plus, if it's not integral by part, what should we do?
So it becomes like this, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the first part equal to? Let's calculate it out. With what?
Truth, it shouldn't be a calculator.
Without brains! We just need to sum pi over 2 in. Wait a second, cosine pi over 2 is a 0. Sum 0 in. Wait a second, sine 0. Still a 0.
If it is nice, don't use a calculator.
So basically, this now is a positive.
Okay.
So, for this, now, is this all right?
Yes.
I put a constant there inside, okay?
Never, forever.
Okay, never mind. I'll just change their places.
Okay.
Because that will look more better.
Nicer.
So we have here a cosine square x.
Really?
Obviously.
Okay.
Now why is there a weird c doing here?
Cosine square x. You're tricked. No, because why I want to do this. The cosine square x first, then I'll do that step.
Because we can straight away use that trigonal identity.
I didn't. I just done it step by step.
Now, can you separate them?
Yes, we can.
But do you know how to continue?
I know how.
Huh? So you write it out now.
Expand.
That's what I said, but how to expand this?
Expand the here times this, then this part.
So can you write that out?
Fine, if you say so. So here.
Continue.
Okay.
Wait a second, why is it a CN? Yeah, that's more like it.
There's no CN brackets. Here, okay.
Wait a second, you still have a cosine? Where did you get that? I don't see any cosines.
Hehe. Hehe. You need to follow a mistake. Like dx.
At this part, something.
Same. Emma.
Same. So?
So? Half? Half?
Sure?
Yeah.
Then you're wrong. Because when you put this there, it's an n minus 1 plus 1 becomes an n. The denominator that divides here is an n. Because it's not two of them add together, then you divide that 2.
Okay.
So you can continue with that.
So here we vary. We change it to 1 minus 1 over n.
Why would you want to do that? This is the end.
Ta-da.
Of nothing.
What?
Because this is just a reduction formula. We need to keep using this. So that will become n minus 1 over n times whatever. Now what kind of case is this? I wonder what is it?
So n minus 1 over n minus 1.
N minus 1 over n minus 1. Where did you get that?
Definitely.
Isn't it n minus 3 over n minus 2? That's more like it. Now I have a question for you. Why is it square root pi over 2? Can you write out what are those? If you don't get it, what I mean, let me just tell you. Like, which one do you want? Is it n is even or n is odd?
Even.
So when it is an even, what did you get square root pi? Let me tell you what this is actually. So at this part, wait, magic,
abracadabra.
So it becomes like this. Okay, 5, 3, 1, no times, bigger, I can't see it. So then you guys need to write this part. Now what happened there? answer, right?
Okay.
So, do you want me to say one more thing?
I got P, I want S.
So this is one method.
N1 method 1.
Then how about method 2? Can we continue with method 2?
Oh.
But first, well, before we start method 2, let's revise something.
It is a beta and a gamma,
Only beta.
No gamma.
So, let me give you questions and you will solve them. Okay?
Okay.
Hello, are you solving?
Okay. I was just waiting for you to write out all the questions. Okay? Just now.
Well, when I was writing, you can already start.
Okay, fine.
Let me just ask you, where is gamma 1?
1.
Yes, correct, it is a 1. Sure?
Yeah.
Okay. So you passed this time.
Only for the first question, right?
Yeah. Are you so sure about that?
Yes.
Let me see. Okay. Okay, so you passed the second. Third, fourth, fifth, you're a bit harder. But still quite simple. Let me just change this question a little bit.
I don't want you to change.
This one.
What did you wrote?
8. I'll make this question easier for you.
Why? Give you one question, the hardest of all. Okay. Your hardest question. Why you say cannot?
What is your DX?
Okay, fine. It goes to cannot.
So, for this part, so hard, how do I expect you to solve this? But actually,
I know how. Let me solve or not.
Something like this?
Wait. You haven't solved it yet. You haven't truly solved it yet. Try not. And it's correct.
Oh, you just want this part?
It's correct, but you must finish it.
You mean I must change it into something times, times, times all the way?
Yes.
But now, this would then give me four cases. Uh-oh.
Write down all four cases.
Well, but actually, usually we only need to go until here. Then, even better is when you simplify this.
For what reason?
So, usually we just write until here. Because, right, four cases you need to write so much. In fact, it's very easily mistaken.
Then you write that the next step, Ken. Can write that the next step?
So question three, you realize your mistake, hey?
Why a lot? Why you say mistake, hey? So
there I go.
So complicated.
There I go. I found the answer. So you're basically saying that is correct.
Yeah.
So, third question, is it difficult?
You never found my mistake. Why number nine?
Here.
And why you two here?
Easily mistaken, right? Isn't it?
Yeah.
Let me show you a trick. Do you want to know a trick?
Wait.
Okay, tell me if you want to know about the trick.
No.
How did you know that trick?
Simplify, okay. Simplify, simplify, simplify.
Which language can simplify?
First, these two.
Yes.
These four and these four.
Yes.
These four and these four.
Yes.
And left with this.
Yes, exactly. This is, it might look very difficult, right?
Yeah.
But look at this answer. How simple is it? Right?
Look. How difficult. Yay. So happy. We could simplify nearly everything. 21. Okay?
Okay, so you can continue with question number 4. Meanwhile, output takes. So after you finish all, I will tell you your score.
Ha ha, so easy. Did you give this easy peasy question?
Just to test whether you know the basics.
I think I know why. So that you want me to get confused. Okay.
Very easy, right?
But what is 6 factorial? What is?
Okay, let me just tell you, definitely write in factorial. I don't need anything else.
You don't need?
Yeah.
But later you still need to do that.
I say from you.
Pick.
Want?
Okay.
Wow. Very amazing.
Any tips? Because that did the first number and the first number is 6 and here is 6, so we can simplify only for the first number, so it will be easy.
So then you don't need to write all those numbers out, right?
Yes. So don't be dumb to simplify a 2. You should simplify a 6 instead.
Okay. Then, last question. So these we solve these questions to get ourselves familiarized with these fractions.
Ready for either fight or flight. But what I mean is like learning fight or flight. Okay? Okay?
Okay.
Is there a 3?
How are you so sure?
Wait, let me check. Nah. You know why I'm wrong?
What is 6 plus 1? 6 plus 1 is 3, right?
No. So even number we can do, unless you want a fraction, right?
Obviously.
Decimal can or not?
It depends.
But what if it's an irrational number?
Obviously, no.
Rational?
Rational? Depends. Why?
1/3.
Recurring with a pattern, how should you solve for that?
Yes. N plus must be the correct either, must be even number. Okay? Cannot be. N plus, the denominator must be a 2, cannot be other denominator.
Why must be a 2? Because it is 2n minus 1. and 2n minus 1.
If
one
not,
is n, one is n.
But what if you choose 4n? Then this still need to over 4 over 8. Right?
Yeah.
So that would be dumb. Like this.
Let me check. How are you so sure about that?
It's correct.
7 over 2 plus 5 over 2 is equal to 13.
I was just kidding.
It is a 12 over 6 and that is a 6.
Wait, let me first see.
I'm just kidding, it's a 12 over 2. That is a 6. Right?
Yes.
So write it. What are you waiting for?
I'm just checking if you're correct. Okay.
Better with that dot to represent times. At first when you write 25, I thought it was a 25 factorial.
Ow, why 5 factorial? Shall we calculate?
No.
Okay.
But if you want to know, that is a 120.
Yes.
Now, do you know why you have a pi up there?
I know why.
Because you have two of the square root pi's, right?
Yes. So here, no space.
Okay.
Wait. Can I just write it below, okay? Oh no, no space.
Write it to the side at the big whiteboard.
Yep.
Yep. Okay, so you can continue there. So, from this, when you continue with that,
could you explain?
So 7 over 2, how should we know for that? Well, in the past we have proven that gamma n is equal to n minus 1 times what? Gamma n minus 1, right?
Okay.
So we have proven this. So, right now, we can apply it here.
Oh.
Wait, is it something that simple?
I think so.
Okay, then continue.
Oh, a tool party.
So basically there is 2 to the power of 6, right?
Yes.
Which makes 8 times 8. Well, that is quite simple.
64.
Yes, 64 times 5 factorial. But it is better if you simplify the 5 out there with the 5 factorial. Isn't it? Sure.
Yeah.
So, I think you got a right answer.
So tell me, what's my
full marks?
Okay. So now, what would we do now?
So now we've got ourselves familiarized with these things. So we can start with the second method here, okay?
Okay.
Okay. So erase everything?
Only here, okay. First, the other side will erase here, okay? Okay? Next?
Okay.
Let me play.
Now, the second method. So, for this second method, well, that is, we'll use the beta function. Right?
Okay!
And this is still when n is an even number.
Yeah!
So, for this, well, if we want to use this beta function, well, first, this is an even power, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it like this?
Yep.
Is it like this?
Yep.
So now, let's just say this is n, that is m.
Okay. Okay.
So in this way, it will be like, let n be, so 2 or this thing, 2.
Yes.
Okay, so in this case, because at first for this, it is like, like this, right? So we just change the M for P, N for Q, okay?
Okay.
So for this, we'll still have minus 1, right?
Yes.
Then, so P. What is this? So now we change this. Right?
Yes, sir.
So, P. How should we find this? N plus 1 over 2, right?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Then if M is equal to 2 cubed minus 1, so that means Q will be equal to M plus 1 over 2, right?
Okay.
So that means you can find it for his.
Why is it his?
I meant to say this
in a word, okay.
So, is it right? Is it right?
Yes, it did. I think it's correct.
now. N plus 1 over 2 plus half. How do you find that?
I don't know.
So that means this will be the N over 2 plus the 1.
Yes.
So with this, we can erase this part.
Yes, sir.
So for this, well, that means we'll just need to use the one I wrote before.
What the one that you wrote before?
Let me write it again.
At least you could say it out accurately.
Now what is this part?
I think it. Actually it's a n minus 1.
So for this, well, minus a 1. Minus another 1. Now this part is easily confused because that's a plus, this is a minus. Right?
Yeah.
So this goes all the way until. Now what is this? And also this is an even, right? So that means, wait. Odd over even, right?
Yeah.
Right? So we can only be all the way until 1 over 2. Right?
Yeah.
So then we'll divide it by. And also there is a gamma half. That is square root pi. Am I right?
Yes.
Stop it.
Okay.
So, now at this part. Wait a second, you didn't realize something.
I know it.
Then say it.
That you haven't finished writing it.
Because this square root pi belong to the one in the front. And this square root pi belong to the gamma half.
If not, it would be so lonely. Right?
Okay, so for this, 2 times. Now this stuff at the bottom.
Why that stuff then?
We have n over 2.
Why the stuff
then? We have n minus 2 over 2. We have n minus 4 over 2 times whatever.
Let me ask you, should we suck?
So like this is it, right?
Yes.
Now let's check how many numbers are here. Should we?
I don't think so.
We should to check whether we need an extra 2 or we just need to use this 2 up, okay?
Okay.
Are you going by counting? I just saw you count.
So,
let me tell you. And we don't know. How should you count when you don't know what's the number?
Keep on counting.
Then, how much time do you need?
Infinity.
Cannot.
Why?
Okay, so let me show you this better way, okay?
Okay.
So, n. At first, it's n minus 0, right? Right?
Yup.
Then this goes all the way until.
So, you hear
when it is a 2. What is this actually? It's like this, right?
Yeah.
So, you minus. Divided by 2 because they skip by 2. And wait a second. You need a plus 1, right?
Yeah.
So what you get is an n over 2.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yes.
So basically, at the denominator, excluding these two here, we have n over 2 terms. Then, let's see in the numerator. We have n minus 1 all the way until n minus bracket n minus 3, right?
Yeah.
Sure?
I say alakazam means sure. Just kidding.
See, you didn't realize it again.
Because I was just kidding with my alakazam.
So that means we need to use this minus. Now it becomes a 2. Then u plus 1.
Wait, isn't it the same thing?
Okay. That means we'll have still n over 2. Right?
Yay.
So that means these all the 2 that the denominator, they can just simplify peacefully.
Bye bye.
Bye.
Bye bye, tools. Bye bye, all the tools at the numerator and all the tools at the denominator of the denominator. Then what will you say? Bye bye, all the tools that go into the. That at this either the denominator of the denominator or the numerator of the denominator, okay?
Okay, so right now here we have this. So is it the same?
Yes.
Yay, we got it.
Yay, yeah.
But this is not the end.
Why?
Hoi, this is just even.
And then we'll try again. Means that why is that math? By the and then we'll try again means that if an odd number.
Yes, let's go on.
Because we are not restarting this whole thing, okay?
Yes, exactly.
Yes.
But right now, mainly we will need to learn about these functions, okay? Not about those general reductions, okay? So, let's also start with this. So now for this part, that means we also have something similar, can we? Can we have something similar?
Yes.
So that means we also have something like this, okay?
Yes.
Now it's getting easier, isn't it?
Yes.
So we can already change it into the beta function, right?
Yes.
So that means we change it into something like this.
Okay. Let me go.
So for this, and So you still have n plus 1 over 2 and a half, right?
Wait, can we just use this answer?
No, no, no. This is an odd number. That is an even number. We can't straight away use it. Well, then I ask you, is 2 and 1 the same?
No, the difference is 1.
Well, then there's always a difference.
A very small difference?
I don't know. Because I don't know why it's n. So here, we will still have our gammas. And also, don't write double gamma like this. Don't write it like this. This is the ceiling function.
And don't accidentally write the gamma like this. Okay, don't accidentally.
That's the floor function.
Yes. There only could be one. But don't think because that you can't like this. So excuse me. Since you say cannot like this, right? Then why can't I do it like this?
What is double gamma? So for this, you can just try to simplify them.
Okay.
Into like this.
Okay. Simplify.
So next, we also have another long chain.
Really?
But yes. Be careful. Odd number plus an odd.
Odd plus odd. Even.
Yes, correct. It is even. Then divided by even?
Even divided by even, of course, odd. Just kidding.
Even it depends.
Divided by even, it depends. Even like 2 and 2 odd, it just depends.
Okay, so right now for this.
Continue.
Well, that will mean at the numerator. Well, what kind of numbers do we have? Okay, well, obviously all of them have over 2, right?
Yes.
So first, minus 1. Minus 1. And also it's a whole fraction minus 1. Then, so up here is an even number. So you can go from 4 over 2, 2 over 2, right?
Yes.
Then we here have a square root pi.
Let me ask you, can we simplify?
Not now, later.
Okay, if you say so.
So now we have this extra 2 here, right? Which is very annoying.
Annoying with the 2.
So here, but we'll still continue with the rest first.
Yes.
So, in this case, n over 2, n can only be an odd number, right?
Yes.
So that means it goes 3 over 2 and a half.
Yeah, bye.
Then you have the square root pi from itself, right?
Yep.
Then, how many terms do we have here?
Yes.
How many terms? I'm asking you.
I know how many. That's why n minus 0 to n minus n minus 1. So there are n terms of n terms minus 1 over 2. That's it. N minus 1 plus 1 become the same thing. Okay, so n minus 1 over 2 plus 1, which equals to 2.
Right?
Yeah.
Then next, how about the numerator?
Numerator same, I think. Why is it n minus 1 over 2? Is it?
So that means here, wait, we have one extra tool or one lesser tool?
One, yeah.
Sure about that?
Yeah, of course.
So what does that mean? So what now we have lesser two, one lesser, right?
Yes. You faster. What's the matter now?
Wait a second, you didn't realize this. Well, n minus 2 minus 1. So basically, these two vanished.
Vanished into DNA magic. What are you doing?
So here, n bracket n minus 2 bracket all the way. Oh wait, not bracket all the way.
Not bracket.
I mean times all the way.
Let me just tell you, if you say bracket all the way, it becomes like this. Okay, it should be times.
Okay, so we have this, right?
Yep.
Same.
Play the.
So, in this lesson, are you clear so far?
Yeah.
So now we've got the right things. And we've proved it. Finally.
And you understand, right?
Yeah. So, do you have anything else to say or ask?
I have nothing else to say about this, but something else to say. But you are wrong.
Why?
Two places wrong, both are wrong. You didn't show everyone.
Show.
This one you didn't show everyone.
No, I don't show. I prove it. Can I write like that?
Okay.
So let me just write this properly.
Wait, let me ask you something first.
Yes.
What does?
That's a 5. Like this.
Okay, much better.
Okay, so if you like our videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
Okay.
And we have many of these things.
Do you mean continue? Hope you like our videos. Tune in for more.
Thank you for your watching.